And this guy that he went to work for, teaching, was playing with me. And at that particular time, he hadn't gone to this way that O'Grady teaches. And he's hitting the ball pretty good. I mean, real good. But I shot the first side 5 under. Then they put out some damn amateurs, and we had to wait about an hour and a half or 2 hours. And I got cooled off, and I shot one over on the backside. But that's because when you get things going, you hate to stop in the middle of it, you know. You lose the thrill of the excitement of those finishing the first 9 5 under, you know. That all I've seen is the results. I don't question a thing. I don't try to deter them away from the teacher. I just look at their results, and I want to vomit. I mean, to watch the average person teach, you go to the courses. I had one man who's head of physics, UCLA. He brought his wife down to my range. And she took it as shorthand information. He went to every known golf pro in the Southern California section. He came back and he says, Mike, I'm going to take up kinesiology at UCLA because it looks like what you've got here is so superior. And I'll know when I take it up just how superior it is. And a man, his name is Jimmy Hines. He owns a hell of a lot of plants. I told him, you started teaching. I says, when the hell don't you open up some plants? He did. He became a multimillionaire, you know. Instead of drawing teachers' pay, he got these manufacturers successful pay, you know.
Have a lead letter book now. Have you seen that?
I haven't seen it. I know I went back to a deal in Wisconsin, Milwaukee, and they had this grout, and they had Byron Nelson. They had a bunch of pros from all over. And I kind of felt sorry because they asked me to do a deal on kinesiology. Well, hell, it's like talking to a person in Greek and they didn't speak it, you know. But they didn't know it was over their head. If I just talk, you know, and told you have to use this muscle, that muscle, it wouldn't mean crap to you. But if I illustrated and so forth, I didn't have but a certain amount of time to go it. And this is a nebulous explanation, you understand? But they wouldn't understand it unless I had 2 or 3 hours to explain it. I've been in 23 countries lecturing to colleges on kinesiology. I did all the analysis for the Japanese government in karate, judo, jiu-jitsu, aikido, kung fu. I got $100,000 for 60 days of work. A big mistake. They said, if you don't want to pay taxes, leave your money here. Buy Toyota stock. Get it for 28 cents a share. Well, it hadn't come to America. Well, it came over. It went to $179 a share. $0.28 to $179 a share. You know, I had to pay them 20% tax. You know, I brought back $80,000. You know.
Mike, before we go to lunch, how much did you watch some of these guys hit some balls?
Oh, yeah. And, I mean, do your people understand what I've said? Well, I will tell you one thing. There is no better way to hit the ball than this. Give him more power and more consistency. But you see, you're dealing now with a lengthily trained reflex pattern. It takes a lot of balls and a lot of determination to stick with this, you know, before you can make the change. Just because you know it doesn't mean you can do it. You've got to train muscles and nerves. And working with nerves is like working with wild animals. You can make, hell, I saw a man teach bears how to dance. He put tuxedo and evening gowns on bears and they could waltz, they could foxtrot, they could poker, you know. And I said, man, Dale, it was a world fair. I said, hi, Dale, did you do that? I'm demonstrating golf there. He says, I've got a cage. Underneath the cage, I got gas jets and holes in. I light those things, turn on the poker, and they'll dance to that poker. That's why I taught them. I turned on the walls and they did to that. Then I had a damn guy there that was take a horse and he'd get in the bed and he'd pull the sheet over him. And I had a dog that would play a piano. They had keys like big enough for the dog to play it. He's playing God Bless America. First thing you show him the basics, and that's what I like to do before we go to lunch, okay? All right. And after making the address, oh, you stand up here, do it, no. I just want to make the address. The first move we're going to make, you get over here, we can do it, I'll step down here. Now, this is a Y, right? I'm not going to break the wrist. I'm going to let him shift his hip into that and turn. That's the first movement, the shift into the left. Now, you see there, now go the other way. Now that's the body action. So you have a shift and a rotation of the shoulders, right? The club is separating from the ball. Now that's a constant now, without the accelerating force, which I'll give you in a moment with the hands. Okay? You see there, his left leg is holding him up. That leg, left leg, the shoulders are turning, right? But you're only turning a certain degree because you're not breaking the hands or the right right elbow. But now...
That's not too stiff.
No, this is not too stiff. I can hit it with that thing like that because I know... To lift the heel, I got to break it. And I use this femoris bicep to do that. And if
oh,
you don't...
Through.
Yeah. So I say, I mean, as long as you learn this exercise, I don't give a damn what you do with that.
Uh-huh. Mike, if this knee stays flexed, this hip...
It's people back on you.
Back.
You back.
This way.
Yeah. That's right. Now you feel support. I tell you what you do. When I get on this thing like this, I can hold up three men, right there. You can hold up one. Do that. Now, did anybody see any objection to this way of swinging? Now, that's motion.
So if the knee stays flexed, you're going to get more of a reverse pivot?
Yeah. Get back up. You do a posterior rotation to the right hip. Now this is a posterior rotation right hip, and you stay on your left. No, it'd be a little bit more on the left because you see to address the thing, you move over a little bit like that to lower the right shoulder. Now, look at that! Look at that! Look at that's beautiful! Beautiful!
That's where it stops.
Huh?
Right there. You see that? That's beautiful too, isn't it? Now, I'm going to show you something. We're going to do hand action, okay? Now, we're going to keep this still. We're going to move this right hand into hyperextension. That puts the left wrist in palm of flexion, okay? Now we come through here like that. Do that. Now, this is a short one, just a short movement. Now, we combine those. You take a first class.
Mike, I can see that I was sitting over there. I'd like to watch that again. You're aware of control. That's the hand action.
Okay. No, I'm not moving the arms at the moment. I'm moving hands. I do what this is called a dorsal flexion of this right hand. Now, I'm doing a slight palm of flexion, but the elbow is turning a little bit. You see? Now, as you come forward, now just let that loose and let it come that way. Now pick up that heel and let it go. See, they had to stay and look there. They had to, excuse me, do that.
But when I, when I watch this, I see Rick do this with his hands. Later on, you're going to let the shift
do it, yeah.
And follow that,
yeah.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
You're doing it with your hands. This is just a hand drill.
This is a hand drill, just to show them how to use their hands. Combine the now the shift and then a turn, you get a full swing, understand?
But you sort of got to go in this way more than that.
If you want to fight that left field all day, you go that other way.
The mic, when it gets here, eventually you're going to rotate up here.
See, the wrists will come together here. So when you hit the ball, now let me show you something. When you hit the ball, now that isn't here, that's the dress. When you hit the ball, you're there. Now, well, hold it, stay there. Now, see, this right hand hasn't completed its action yet. This is a straight line from the club head up to the left shoulder.
Uh-huh.
Now, as this comes, like, now the wrists will come together like that, and then they'll turn over.
Oh, okay.
Huh? Yeah. Wrists come together. Uh-huh. No, you're too tight. Man, you know, you got that thing locked up in your arms. That way.
Okay.
And then turn and over.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. This one. Okay.
You come now. I'm going to bring this together. Watch. No.
Like that.
Yeah, and then turn over.
Okay.
Let it go into the
Then come back in.
You understand?
Turning over just going more or less half. You don't.
Ah, yes, that's right. Yeah, that when you break that left arm, see that'll turn it over. Don't lock this thing this way.
For the average starting golfer, how much training is there involved in getting them to do that?
It actually, if you take a person who never had a golf lesson, it is so easy. And women, because they normally walk with the hips working this way, a man walks with his hips level. A woman walks with a tilting hip action. You see, a woman walks this way, this way, this way. And that's where you swing. And it's 7 years added to your life walking that way. You walk this way, stiff like this, you stubbing up those spine, cutting off the circulation to your brain.
That's what our problems are. Hmm? Walk for that way.
So, now shift. That's right. Man, I tell you, see that ball go right there. You come around and walk like this, and you're going out of. See, there's so much. This is crap. That turns the blade, but doesn't advance the shaft. This advances the club. I'm hitting that ball, man. I'm just knocking the crap out of it with the head. I'm not coming here and kicking this thing there with the arm and locking the wrist and turning the hand under. You know. Good. See, it doesn't convolute. Now, convolute is like that. Yeah. It stays on plane.
Close to this.
Hmm?
So if that was the target line, Mike, the edge of that stage.
Yeah.
Okay. Half of that club head now, after you hit it, it's going more over it?
Yeah, it's coming down. Yeah, it's coming down the fairway until you come to here. Mm-hmm. And it turns over and it comes there.
So it's going down that line more.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. But no, I'm not doing here. I'm letting a 180 degree pendulum action take forth around the base of the wrist. Now this is only half of a semicircle. Now this is the other half. Look at the acceleration. Look at the acceleration and the energy now get into the club head, which creates centrifugal force. Now look at this. Now take it here and do this. I'm swinging, my body's swinging the same speed, but that club is, can you see that?
Do you feel the feeling of under and up?
Mm-hmm. I shift this way into convection on the left side, concave in the right. Well, I don't make that happen. I let the club head do it. And it doesn't ever get into that degree that you went into. Okay? That way. You see, I'm trying to drive the ball up. I always carry the ball. I never want it to roll. I want it to hit and stop. And see, my ball all carry. I don't have to worry about bounds. Those rolling balls, this is the one you
You're trying to keep this loose as possible?
Not loose, no. Free. I got enough grip here to hold that club up. I'm not squeezing it and locking it. The shaft to the left shoulder. I've got a hinge here, and if you don't use that, the third lever is non-usable. Here, look. Look at this. First lever is from the elbow to the shoulder. That's working just as the body going. Second lever from the elbow to the hand. Third lever, hand to the club head. Aye. But don't stop your body. Don't stop your body. You stop your body, and your hands will get this way before you hit the ball. I don't want the hands that way until like way out here. Now go. There, and then over. Stays right on plane. Let the elbow raise after it goes high. Up. Go ahead. Up. Let the elbow raise. You want to keep that radius. That bar. Is this a little bit different than your people thought? It's quite a bit different than a Wii, is it not?
Well, with I think we're more in tune with it. The position of his hand after impact would turn more, opposed to flexion.
Yeah, well, see,
that's... Keep that wrist flat, Mike.
Yeah, but it's only flat 1 degree impact. And it goes out of flatness into a big extension. Then the energy is free. It's coming out like a bullet coming out of a gun barrel. Same speed as the arm, so you're reducing it to arm speed. I get the third lever of the hand.
That's another dimension of the golf.
You'll see the club coming out almost like the head meets each other, but it's going to be a little bit above. And a lot of people think a loop and a swing, it isn't. When you move off of this movement here to that movement, this is XY, this is AB, your XY is elongated, understand? So you have one circle going back like this, and you come this way, and you have another circle. It looks like a loop. You don't. Understand?
Yeah, because it's inside this.
Yeah, it comes in with the flexion.
It's done through the shift.
Yes, sir.
There's no
loop. Now,
Michael, now, will you get a flattening effect of the club shaft? And they talk about that a lot to you.
It's called whatever flex you have in it is how much it drops down. See, when you have two flexions in the shaft, you have a flexion. It drops down below the parallel. It flexes this way. And as you start, the coefficient of that thing starts like it, and it'll bend the head. And when you hit in here, you have a common lane between if you photograph it at 4,000 frames a second, you can see how the shaft is not a straight line. It's like this. If you got too much flex, it'll get in there through the flexion a little bit ahead like you're cooping your hand, you see? But if you have the right flex, it'll be a line there, common line.
You often mention that you don't want to move your arms faster than your body. That's pretty much true. You want them to stay just like a satellite.
Yes, yes, but you see, you're gaining this amount of energy in that club shaft and head through the pendulum action. My club is traveling twice as fast as my left arm.
That wouldn't have to take effect without the wrist action.
Yeah.
That's not so much automatic.
It's a matter of letting a muscle that is contracted going back to a state of rest, and the time it takes to go from a state of contraction to a relaxation or state of rest is a tonus, you know, and a latent period of muscles. The latent period of muscles is that time to get back to the state of rest. And yet, like somebody, like a Stephen Fletcher, he speaks very slow. He'd have a very slow reaction because that's the way his brain works. Take a specimen like talks like that Canadian that you're talking about. He's got a very fast, you know, motion.
Mike, the motion of that left arm on the back to the beginning, the left hand, is it going to turn?
You don't turn first. Shift and bend a little bit. See, it'll rotate it slightly. You don't, you know, when you, as your right elbow bends, it causes it to rotate. Yeah, the right elbow bending causes the left arm to rotate.
The opposite, the right elbow straightening causes it to rotate it back.
Yeah.
So the point of the right elbow bends is when the left forearm rotates.
Mm-hmm. I'm going back this way. See, when I grip the club to have the heel of the hand on top, I don't grip it like this and have the side. I'm on top. My hand is slightly, and it's not in extension, it's slightly in that way, see? I don't grip this way and come underneath the club. I grip this way. You hear me that? Look, I don't grip this way. I grip now. If I put that club just like that, I don't have a straight hand. As I come back and get it straight. So my left hand is coming into that position and then turning, you know, so I do a radial flexion and have it plane of the golf club where it should be. And this is coming this way and relax that pronatus muscle come back to square. Latent period of muscles from relaxation to the state of rest. And everyone has a latent period of that thing, and then it's different with everyone to certain degrees, you know. And see, the things that work muscles are acetylcholine. It's a liquid in a system, and you have electrical stimulation from a brain, and that acetylcholine is just like putting vinegar on your tongue. It causes a contraction. That's what that does when you stimulate that, and it's just like adding an electrical shock, then it causes a contraction. You know?
People get the risk.
Your club is off plane. They want to feel like they're cocking, but they uncock in their left hand when they do this. The hand's uncocked when it's there. The hand this way, now you can come and use the third level. You can't use the third level in this position. You understand that?
Putting their hand in the club incorrectly would help cause that as well.
Well, usually if you put the hands this way to get up there, they want to feel something, and they'll do that with it.
Well, if they get much the other way.
Well, they'll cause you to turn the blade too much before you hit the ball. Because you've gone into a pronation before, you start a swing. You're in a pronated position that way. You want to stay to non-pronation, non-supination, but there's a slight hop extension to get the heel of the hand over the club. Well, you do watch every woman on the tour. They all have a strong left-hand grip. Right? Almost everyone. And if you watch most of the players, it's just like you have a wet rag. And you come here and you twist one hand this way and one hand that way, and you get a solidness in the grip. Yeah. You feel that? Like the club grip is a wet towel. You're going to squeeze the water out of it by turning one hand against the other. Well, no, sir. They're coming through with a pulling action. See, he pulls. He doesn't pull. He didn't rotate the left side from the left spinae erect. He does it with a lat, and that shortens up a little bit, like it causes him to cut across the ball. You know. Well, I haven't seen him swing. He possibly does, but you don't want an inflection here. You want an extension. You want it flat.
Yeah.
Well, you can come on and up that way, but that's making a loop and a swing. Understand? The way we do it, we don't have to loop.
How would you, when it's windy, how would you hit a low shot and just put the ball back?
Well, you can put it back and hit down into it, but it rises quick. But you can, because when you play it back, you are reducing the loft of a club. But if I want to hit a driver and hit it low, I play it forward and catch it on the upswing with the bottom half of the club.
What about an iron?
I play it back toward the right foot, and called punt shot. Now, see, when you go out to the hitting area, I'll show you how to punch a ball low, hit it high, hook, high hook, low hook, high slice, low slice, fade, you know.
I got one question. Rick was talking, Dave was talking about this one. He said Freddie Couples, who's one of the longer hitters on the tour, would get the one he calls a turbo release.
Yes, but see, he comes out of it. He's got it in a bad position, but he drops it immediately, and he's coming back that way.
He always seems to be swinging so smooth.
He's got a good shoulder turn, good shift. But see, that's putting in a bad position, but eradicating it before it got back to impact. Yeah, I mean, it's hell. You take Cupid used to come back like this, and you know, and that. Milababa, like that, you know. Then he comes back, and then he gets it straightened about by like, he come down and hit it fairly well, you know. But whatever mistake you make, if you can eradicate it before you get back to the ball, you know, that's well and good. But why do a mistake? Why have motion that's unnecessary? You want to make the motion as simple as possible. I increase the shift speed and hand speed.
Well, I'm just talking about, say, your irons, you know, because you want to be accurate. You want to hit your irons a certain distance. And it seems like that you have more variation. As your irons got longer, you might have more variation as you get different shots.
Well, the longer iron is played near the left foot. You're according to the lay of the, that we call the lead of the club.
You know what I'm saying? When you say you're hitting a 3-iron 230 yards.
Yeah.
Is there more variation for hitting it over the grain or short or whatever, or do you think it would still be?
Well, no, you see, when you decide what tempo you use on a swing, you're not trying to get the maximum distance on a golf course. When you're playing, you use a cruising speed. And I use a count of 1,001, 1,001. I do it a little bit faster than a second. And I hit that ball, and I'm just controlling the arc of the club head. Yeah, well, in 85, I'm 75. They check my swing at 133 miles an hour. I used to be up around 160. Nicholas swings 116. But he's not trying to drive a contest, a driving contest, you know.
Some people are built differently than others. Some people's arms might hang more turned in,
yeah,
turned out. Does that affect how you hold the club? Does you grip it differently?
Just put your palms together. Just put the palm to palm. Palm to palm. Right there. Regardless of whether it, that's it. You set them where they are that way. So this radius is on the outside of this ulna. Now, if this is back in here, that's a strong grip. When you hit the ball, it'll cause it to do that. You know?
Now, let's say if someone hangs with their hands like that, you still want them to get this way.
Yes, sir.
What if they have their hands arms hanging out like that?
You got to hear, they got to get them in here. It's, if they're going to get a good golf swing, you got to be that way. Now, you take, it's a lot of way of walking, understand? There's certain races have a slew foot, certain people have duck foot, like, you know. And you want to stand as near to your normal position of your slant of the feet where this pronated inward or slewed out, you know. But you don't want to get wide with that right foot like that. It'll block out that right side, yeah. but the left foot should be open.
Mike, are you aware of there's a guy that's been functional, having your body functional, and he says that everything's lined up and feet are straight ahead and all that type of thing? Is that anything that you've dealt with in kinesiology?
It doesn't line up with the proper use of the joints.
I mean, when you're just standing, not playing golf, just standing.
Oh, yes.
So if you're out that way, do you...
Then it's a malfunction. You got to get it. You see, you have convulsions of the spine. Hell, I just put my knee into the shoulder blade and put back onto that, finally straightened him up, you know. You have this one side lower than the other. We got to do counteractions to those shortening of muscles. It's probably, he had an injury at one time, and one muscle got locked up on him, and you had to stretch it back to where it squares them up. That's physical therapy you do. You're working with the muscles and the bone structure.
What can you do when you see somebody say you don't have time to help them get straightened out? What do you do as far as the golf?
Well, you can show them how to move the left hip into a convex position, lower the right, and they can get into position. You have to show them that, you know. You can't let them work according to their defects. You got to, if they want to get proficiency, you got to correct the defect.
Would that cause any injury to them?
No, sir. It'd be, helpful to them. I'm teaching a man right now who's got a quarter of his brain knocked out. No left side at all. His leg is stiff as it can be. And on the three-par golf course, he shoots about 40. A quarter of his brain is in a water ski accident. And the propeller of the boat that he was riding in ran over him, cut off. They put a plate in the back, you know. And the guy's doing quite well. He's in it backhanded, right-handed. And he does pretty well. I mean, he doesn't have much movement in the body. But, I had put him in a position where he can maintain balance and still swing that golf club. You know? Balance on a swing is what you have to have. See, kinesthetic motion is balance in motion, see? If you don't have that, you're not going to have any good golf scores.
Work with Jeff Sager recently.
Yeah. One hip is shorter than the other. And hell, you look at him swing the ball. Now, he's going to send you a film of what we did out there the other day. He looks as good as any pro on the tour right now. Not anyone on the tour. You know. He was convoluting and coming around here instead of staying on the plane. I got him to shift more than what he was shifting. And you can't tell any defect on his hip. You know, you can't.
His right hip is higher than his left.
Yes, you know, but you don't look at it now and see it.
Uh-huh.
It looks beautiful, this one.
Because of that setup, the way he sets up like that,
yeah.
That restricted his shift on the backswing, you think?
Well, you see, I set him more into the left.
Then made him shift to the right.
And then a shift to the right and back. So you can't see any of that. His left knee is working correctly now. It wasn't working correctly. The shaft was laid off to left field, which caused your outside in swing instead of having it here. All, if you turn your shoulder a little bit more, it'll go a little bit toward the right field. But it also lets you bring it in on the proper plane. You see? So he was pull-hooking the ball, smothering it. Now he start hitting it, boom, 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 just like that hand is going. Not this way, pulling down into a convolute like a wrapping ribbon around from my neck down, around like that.
You're talking about balance, Mike. What am I just talking about with the knee is hanging? There, I read the same thing Charlie talking about with alignment. When I set up my knees, this is just the way I play hockey on my leg.
Yeah, but you don't want to lock up those internal buses.
You want to be more
no, sir, you don't want it. It'd be natural. That's natural.
I just wondered if that would affect my shift at all, because when I do try to put them out...
Well, then your knee will bow out on you, and your head will move.
So it's more it's better just to let them just hang more.
Yeah. See, I don't go into squat position, because the more you squat, the more you have to raise to hit the ball.
The more you flex or squat, the more you have to raise.
Yeah.
I'm going to go out and hit the ball before lunch. Lisa's first.
Now, move. That's you. Beautiful. Honey, you have to bend over a little bit more for that. But now I want you to move your leg like that. Look here, don't put this hand on first. I want to give you the right. Now you feel like you got a measurement from your left shoulder to the ball.
Okay.
I'm going to make the right hand conform to that pattern, okay?
Okay.
I'm going to move you a little bit over that way like this. And as you move, you're flexing this hip a little bit and this knee. Don't do the other one.
Well.
Like that.
Okay.
Go on that. That'll fit down there. Now, you have a correct measurement from this hand to this shoulder and a correct measurement to that shoulder. Now, to come away from that ball, we are going to... No, sir, you didn't... This knee, let me show what this does. Let me show you. If that knee doesn't pull back, you don't have support. You go this way. That knee, this quadricep, this four muscle comes in, pull it back. Pull that kneecap back as you... Now, do it again. Yes. Now, you pick the club up. See, the club went above the plane. See? You break your hands this way, it stays on plane. We'll see. That way. Yeah, okay?
Okay.
You're trying to get the club behind your wrist. Okay. Now that's coming with the plane of the right shoulder, isn't it? And I'm not trying to take this away this way. Your arms are going away from your body in one direction and body's going another. That's bad. Now, be sure that you pull those that muscle back and pull that kneecap back into that joint. Now, one. Now the club is on plane. Mm-hmm. Now, let's let this turn now, this muscle turn. No, sir, you let me show what you did. You did a posterior rotation of the right hip, and your head goes this way. You have to let this hip come into the center lane, okay? You're not shifting. I'm gonna do it for you.
Okay.
Nice. The elbow's off of the hips. Feel like you pick up your left hand with your right elbow like that, but don't flay it. You have the elbow underneath the hand. See, and I want you to wind up this like that. You leave this hip over here. You can't come in. You bring this hip in, and you can get your hands up.
The what?
Bring the left. You concave this in. Inward. I'm shorting the muscle right into here, coming down and in against that hip. I want you to feel like you're shifting against this right here. Shift against this like that. Now go turn it. Now you see you're holding this humerus bone down here. You're holding this down. I'm raising this. Feel like you take your right hand and pull your left thumb up as high as you can pull it and your arm up. Now you get some heat. Did you feel that?
Mm-hmm.
Let me see you. Take this right hand and pull it up. Now look at your arm. Let it impact against this side.
Right.
But you must let this hip come in. Don't try to... There. You see, look. I'm keeping my head here and I move my hips there. You're trying to keep this hip in, and it'll cause you to turn the back shift. Let it move inward. Now you got your right arm packed against your side. Raise the elbow.
I was thinking of my hip.
Okay, you go, listen. Let's do this thing. Now let's raise that arm. Raise it. Now we get up there, we can knock the crap out of it. Straighten that knee. Now, no, I don't want this damn arm down there. Now I don't want it separated from that. I don't want this position. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
Look at that. It feels comfortable. You feel all bound. I want you to feel unbound, all right?
Okay.
Shift. See, that's, now you collapse his knee like a grasshopper. Look here. I went that way. Anybody tell you keep that knee flexed? They got AIDS. Get away from them. Let's go back now. Come on. You see, you're all bound up in here. You're trying to confine that damn bone against your side there, the humerus bone. Let it raise. Look at mine. Uh-huh. If I have a tray and I want to carry it above my head, I'd raise my elbow. Uh-huh. I'm not going to get it above my head unless you raise the elbow. Let's see you do it. Now shift into that. That's better. But you feel all tight here?
Yeah. Look,
I don't feel tight there. Tight again. Yeah, but you're letting your head move back to the right. You want to keep this from moving. Move your hips as far to the right as you can move them. Now straighten your right leg. Now you got some butt. You know, I could let you sit on me and let him sit on you, and I still hold you up with my right knee. You ain't gonna hold up anybody with that. It's collapsing your knee.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see you do it now. Bring it back. See? I want to turn. Understand? But you got your damn elbow confined to your hip. Let me see. Pick it up. Look, can you do this? Not going this way. I want you to... Here's a tray. Can you pick up the tray?
Yeah.
That's what I want. You know, your shoulders are swinging, but the hips are not. Look here. Look here. Yes, you're doing this, and your head is moving back this way. Can't you move this and this, the knee in and the hip in like that, instead of staying here like this and swing?
Well, maybe I can.
Huh? You can. But if you let me show you how you do it.
Okay.
Now, turn. Turn your shoulders. Raise your hands and turn your shoulders. Okay? No, don't try to hold us down here. I want it to raise.
I'm not trying to hold it down there.
All right, let's say you raise it. Pick it up. Pick up your right hand and your right elbow.
My right hand and my right elbow.
Yeah.
Pick it up.
Yeah. But you look at this damn hip. This hip is staying here. Let it come in. When you move your right hip to the right, let your left hip move to the right. Let it move. Let me show you something. There. Elbow underneath the hand, and the hand like that. Do it again. Now move this hip in. This hip in here. Now can you see that? Instead of staying here and going like that. Yeah. Try it again. Now. Yeah. Now move. Straighten the knee and you got it. Straighten it. Now do it again. Straighten your knee and you have it. Straighten. Huh? You know, we're getting up Proville. Okay? Can you see it in this mirror? You see these shoulders are perpendicular now instead of there, they're coming here. You got this right shoulder behind your neck. I want it behind your neck, I don't want it over here.
Okay.
I want it behind your neck. Keep this elbow pointed out that way. The hands have got to be like that and they're comfortable.
Mm-hmm. You put her in the right position so I can get a close up of her. That's the right position for the elbow? Yeah, you got it.
Okay. You got it?
Yep.
All right. Get it up in front here. Mark, I want to see this. I don't want to leave this hip here and do it like that. Look at this. That right hip does a posterior rotation. You let it here. And then this left hip is swinging out instead of sitting and doing that. Now let's go now. No, you're not moving here.
I want to hit you.
I want this and this to move in a swing. No, your head moves. Don't move your head. Now go. It's all right. Go ahead.
Go ahead. Are you all right?
Yeah, hell, isn't. Come on, come on, bring your hip underneath. Bring your hip underneath you. Underneath you. Don't take it out around that way. Underneath, underneath, underneath. Yes. Okay. Bring your hip underneath your belly. You see? Try to bring your hip underneath the belly like that. Straighten the right knee and you got it. Do it again. Raise your hands now when you do that. Now, look in the mirror.
Hi, Martin.
See, your back is to the target now.
Yeah.
Do it again. Now, put your left hip underneath your navel. You see the... Can you see the movement now of the lower part of the body? You're trying to move the top, not move the bottom. Okay. Listen, I'm mean as hell to the people I teach, but I get some results, you know. They call me a tiger. But I don't want to waste my time with someone who won't listen. Bring that hip underneath the navel. I said, right in here. Okay. Now shift. And come. Pick up it. There. And come on around. Okay. Swing. I'm going to get out of the way.
Okay.
That's much better. Lisa, thank you. Did you see a change?
Yeah.
A little more movement on the, now see, you're not, your spine isn't doing a lateral, look here. Let me show you something. Let me have this thing. My spine is doing this, look. The bottom of my spine is coming to here. Now my navel is right over the arch. Now you're coming inside your hips. You're trying to pivot inside your hips, and I'm pivoting outside my hip. Let's take that club and do that. Aye, that's the way to do it. Stand in the mirror, let him see that motion. See, you're moving up against that hip. Yeah. Like that. Now you're going to throw this basket, this football. It's coming like under. Throw it like that now, under. That's good. Now when you come in here, you must have your left hip past your left foot.
Yeah,
you got some balance on your right leg. You can't get balance on your right leg with your right hip inside in here. It'll be on your left leg. But you get here, now I can stand on that leg, you see? But I can't stand on that leg if my hip is turning inside of the ankle. Now, look here. You got these squatty knees. Okay? Now, shift. Not enough. Not enough. The left hip. Move over. Notice it. Look here. If you stood in front of me, I'd knock you about 10 feet with my left hip. Boom. Like that. I want this hip out here. I don't want this hip turning inside of the left foot lane. You understand? Look.
Yeah.
No, heel, pick up the heel, straighten the knee, and go up against the hip, swing the right hip up against the left hip. Yeah, turn the right heel. And I don't want a line like this. I want an upright left leg. I'm doing it. And this knee has to flex its knee and pick the heel up. Yeah, see that knee is popping back into extension. The left knee is popping back to extension. Now don't give me that damn grasshopper jump. Now that's right. All classic golfers used to swing this way. That's a classic position. Now shift. Now.
Not enough there.
You know, narrow your stance a little bit. Now watch what I'm going to do to you. I'm pushing with the gluteus maximus and minimus muscles. See, I'm not pushing with my foot. I'm pushing this hip over. Let me push you. Now, you'll sway like hell if your knee stays here. Now, if it does this, you won't sway. Pull the knee back into the... Now, pick up your right heel. Now, your weight got over on your left leg, didn't it?
Mm-hmm.
You've got to get over on your left leg. Over on your left leg. Now, this side is free to swing. If you don't get over on your left leg, your right side can't swing. Does that make sense? All right, go. Well, look here. Your shoulders are going to stop right here. If you get the hip over here, let me show you. As far as you can get it, as far as you can get it, just bump the hell out of me with your left hip. There. There. That's causing an up movement of the shoulder, under move of the shoulder, and out movement of the club. There. Now, you got to pick that heel up. The only way you pick up the heel is flex the knee. And then drive that right knee around and touch your left knee now. Like that. Drive it around and touch your left knee. You know, not this way. Here. Flex and then turn. Would you stand closer together with your feet? Now do it. Now, I want you to feel, when you follow through, that your right arm is going to stay straight after it straightens out. Right arm is straight. Left arm bends. Hands come up here. And you got this position, and arched in back and boot out belly. Let's see you do it.
Whoa!
Okay, try it again. No, narrow your stance. I want to get... Okay. Now, check. Okay. High right hand. High right hand. Okay. You're still turning. You're still turning inside your left foot. I want to go over here like this and swing. Look here. Let me have the club minute. I want to swing this right hip out this way. Not the left hip back this and come inside. And turn the inside of the left ankle. I want to turn. I'm out there. My hip is here. Now, I'm finishing this way. You're finishing this way. Over, over, over. I fall over. Now, you can't get over there unless you get the foot up. Let me show what you're doing. Look. Let me show what you're doing. You can't shift this way. You can't shift. You got to pick this knee up here.
Okay.
See, you're trying to keep the heel on the ground. If you don't get the heel off the ground, you... Get it up. Get it up. Get up on top of that toe. No, no. Get up and turn it over. Turn it over. Turn the heel over the toe. Over. You like that. Now you're getting through. Now, if you can keep your head back. Keep your head back and move your hip forward. Looks better.
Mike, with Jay swinging the with his knee and foot action.
See, he tries to swing. Now, that's shifting, but hell, you're not off this right foot. I'm off. I pick up, I bend the knee like that. I feel like I pick this knee up and going to kick a midget right in the balls. That's right. Turn. Kick it. Kick it in. No, hell, you're not bowling. I don't want the son of a bitch in foot to go this way. I want to go around that way. Pick it up and go around. Yeah. Pick it up and go around. Now, that's good. No, pick it up and go around. Now your left leg straight bent. I want you, look here. Your knee never gets the way in hell it should. I'm bringing my knee from back here over my right foot up here all the way to that front leg. Let's bring it up. All the way. Bring your knee up to the front of the head. But don't put the neck behind. Let it turn around. Up. Yeah, like that. It's turning into the knee. Right? I don't want to finish here with the naked heel. I don't want to finish here. Look here. Give me your right knee. I want to finish up with the right knee up on the front line. Even with him. Bring it up, bring it up, bring it up. Straighten your left knee. Now you're caught up with your left knee here, didn't you? You're not, you're right here. Huh? Even if you have to slide the foot. Now, Eddie, don't put the damn foot back under. Look here, you're not bowling. Now, look here. Yeah. Okay, now. Now, you see, you're cutting down in off the swing. Look here. You're cutting down. I'm coming here, swinging it up, and the hand's going up the fairway. Let's see you do it. Let the club pull the hands up the fairway. All right, do it again. Up the fairway. Up the fairway. See, you're still not bringing it right knee up far enough. Now, put your foot like this. So you can actually bring your right knee up to there. Snare them way down. 12 inches, not no 30 inches. Now swing, you can get the right knee up to the front line. That's right. Well, you're trying to put the foot behind the other foot. Turn the heel, look here. Turn that damn heel over the toe and let the left knee collapse with against your right knee collapse against your left. Just clap it over, shift. Hell no, you're doing this. You're pulling this way. Look here. Make the knee go out. Let me have it. Stand there. Now, can you make the knee go this way? Like, go out and then turn. Out and then turn. Out and then turn. Out and then turn. Do it slow. The knee is coming out this way and then turn in. Yes, sir. Yeah. So it can get around the left leg. That's better. Now, let the elbows raise after you hit the ball. That's better. Ah, that's a golf swing. Ask him, does it look better? Look at the finish now.
So you want to raise his elbows after the finish?
Yeah.
Both being down.
Yeah. You're cutting it off. You're cutting your convoluting if you leave them down. That's good. That's good. But I want to feel like you got that damn bar in here. You're going to go up to here instead of cut it into there. You know, jamming that plate against your belly. I mean, against your knee.
Excellent.
Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Listen, I'm a little rough, but...
No, I appreciate it.
Jamie, borrow your weapon now.
He's just going up my...
Flex the left knee and let the... Now, do that. The first movement is to do that. Move the hips there. Going to keep this thing right on the center. And you're going to wind up this. Okay? Let's see you do it. Move. Hell no, you're turning. Look here, you're doing a posterior rotation of the right cheek. Posterior rotation. Can't you see what I'm doing here? Look at how I'm putting my hips over here and I keep my head there. My spine is slanted this way instead of this way. Move your hips. Yeah, look at Mr. Torbett. That. Yeah, and feel like your belly button is coming back around over there when you do it. Move against it. That's a little better. Now swing the other way. All right, try it again. Now you're letting your head turn with your shoulders. You're not moving against your right hip. Look, that's what I want you to get. You're going to have to work like a son of a gun until you learn to shift. You can't hold your head still unless you move your damn hips. Do this when your head goes that way. Do this when your head stays here. Can you see that both hips are going this way and they're tilted? That's now. Now let your, look at your left heel raise. That's a little better. Okay. Now, do it again. But I don't want this damn left hip turning inside the right line. I'm turning in line. That's non-shift. Get over here. Now you can stand on that leg. Get over where you can stand. By the hell, you're not letting your left hip come underneath your belly button. Hell no, look here. You're trying to keep this hip here and your head moves this way. Move the son of a bitch and left hip with the right. And he goes, move it. Both hips to the left. To me, to the right. No, you ain't moved your head. Now. Straighten the knee. Where's the right hip? It's inside your left heel, isn't it? Now look, I'm going to get over to this point right here, and when I wind up my shoulders, my right hip will retro to an upright line. I'm now slanting this way. You're slanting this way, and at this point, I'm slanting this way. And when I turn my shoulder, it comes to a line. That damn Hogan ruined a lot of people keeping that right hip inside. You don't move it at all.
Right there?
Hell no. Your head is doing this. Look here. And your hips are staying here and you're doing this. Now, there's a position I'm looking. I'm looking at a slant of the spine this way. My spine is slanted this way. Can you feel like you're going to back shift? Now, let me pull you back now.
Okay.
Pick up the left heel. Go to the ball of the foot. Now, turn that shoulder like that. Then you come. When you finish your backswing, You should be on an upright right leg. Not a way to flex knee. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
That's it, sir. Good. Like that. Yeah, move your damn hips. You don't move them. Shit, no. No, you're doing a goddamn thing with the hips. Can't you see? I'm crippled. I can't even stand it. But I'm standing on that damn crippled leg. Look here. Now, how in the hell can I stand on the leg there? I can't stand on that leg with the hip is up down here. Huh? Roll the left ankle inward. That's a little better. Now you're not so much. Now swing forward. Now, don't let the ankle rotate to the edge of the shoe. When I swing forward, look here, my left heel is off the ground. When I hit the ball on a solid foot on the ground, from toes to heel, if I wear golf shoe 6 months, I got four lines in it because I'm grabbing the sole. When I step down this, I'm grabbing the sole with the toe, and I got a solid left foot, and I'm turning from here down to the ankle. Now move your hips, just like you got hips over there and your head is over here. Yeah, but look here on your back. Now, you see the position you're in. Look in the mirror. You're standing on your right leg, aren't you? Yeah. You don't do it enough. You're doing it partially. I want the son of a gun overdone. To learn it, you're going to have to practice overdoing. Now, don't keep the knee flexed. Pull the knee back into extension. Now, swing forward. Now, when you swing forward, you're letting your arm drop. My arm is elevated here. See, it starts here. When you come back, it's up, and I'm swinging this plane. I'm not swinging back to where my hands were. They're further away from me, a little higher. Pick up the heel. Roll the foot. That's about a nice shift. Okay. Now, when you come back, look here. The right elbow is working like that. That. But no, you're keeping that hip over there. I want this little bitch hip to come underneath the navel. Look at here. I'm bringing my right left hip underneath here. See? And you're keeping this heel going this way. You understand? You're trying to keep your weight on your left foot and get to the right. You can't eat the cake and still have it. You got to digest it. No, I don't want your head over there and your ass over here. I want your ass over there and your head over here.
Okay.
Let it come in. You see what I've done? Look at your belly button's right over your arch, isn't it?
Right.
Over.
Okay.
Huh?
Okay.
Try it again.
You're
not moving this. This thing is standing right here. You're keeping the left hip the same height it is when you dress the ball. It's got to go down about, look at that, my left hip. You're keeping this hip here. You ain't doing a damn thing but turning around here on the level position of your hips. Mine are tilting. Can you see My shoulders are tilted, my hips are tilted. You're trying to do this, and you're trying to keep your hips level. They have to tilt.
Gotta move.
Down. What you're using your head down. You're not moving your right hip to the right. Look, you mean to tell me, hell, you're turning your foot. Look here, can't you do this? Look here, how my, you turn this way and hold this way, you'd all turn with it, level. Look here, my belt isn't turning this way, it's turning this way. Yeah, that way. Now, feel how that drops? Don't try to turn your hips. The turn of the hips come from the wind up of these spinae rectae muscles, okay? Hell no, you didn't shift. Yeah, look here, let me show what you did. Shift over here. Now, stand on top of me with this crippled foot. I'll hold you and eat both of them, just like that. Well, how in the hell can you hold somebody up that way? Well, now your head's behind your foot. Your head is behind this foot. Let me do something to you.
Back.
Let me do something to you. Now, you don't do a damn thing. Let me do it.
Okay.
Keep your head on the center line.
Okay.
There. Now, hold it right there. I want to show you what to do.
Okay.
Now, I want you to wind this muscle. Okay, your head didn't drop.
Mm-hmm.
Now, shift. Straight ahead. Now, wind up that muscle. This way. That's right. You've got to practice that. Is, you see, you've got to know, work against what you've been ingraining.
Mm-hmm.
See, you've ingrained a posterior. This is a posterior rotation of the right hip, and it keeps your left hip here, and they're like that. Now, when you move this way, this is dropping. Your head doesn't drop. Your shoulders turn down.
Okay.
You see, I'm not getting here and turning my shoulders like that. I'm coming underneath. That's good. Now, mm-hmm. Come. Yeah.
Okay.
You see, that's better. Much better. Now go. Forward. Okay? You know, you can't build the Eiffel Tower in a day. You're working with wild animals when you're working with nerves. And it's through repetitious practice, you're able to develop a trained reflex pattern. But you first have the idea precedes your eventuality. You got to have that mental picture of the members of the body that's moving in what sequence and what degree. Okay? That's right. Now you shift to the right foot, didn't you? That's good. Now shift the other way. Look at this thing in the swing up and look at it. No, don't turn your ass. I ain't trying to turn my right. Look here. When I turn the shoulders, now I'm here. Now I'm not turning my ass. But watch when I turn the shoulders, how this foot comes from here and it comes there. It gets turned from the winding up of the shoulders. Okay. Go, now shift. And much better. That looks good. Swing toward the come this, yeah. See how the weight now is balanced on this leg here? See, he can hold it there. Minute. Now, let me show you something.
Yeah.
You could hold me up, couldn't you?
Sure, I could.
You turn this way and I guarantee you couldn't.
Right.
Yeah, the legs are asleep. I got to get out, probably. third level working. Yeah. Here, and it did relax the pronatus muscle, the muscle that causes us to turn, relax that just as you start down and let it club stretch out to the bottom. I don't care if it went right, you got a little bit more release out of it. Yeah. Hit another. You see, if you stop the body, your hands will go into coop position. Look. Stop the body. It can never get in this position here without stopping either the shift or the rotation of the body. You understand? You can hit it as hard as you want to. I mean, as hard as you want to using this system. That's much better. That hand was doing this. You release the third lever, you understand?
Yeah.
Instead of taking it there.
Right.
Okay, next man.
Dave or Lee.
Hold it a minute. Hold it. Mm-hmm. Now I want this to move with this now. Come on. That way. Okay? That way. That takes this whole left side underneath the spine. Understand?
Uh-huh.
Because this is... Now raise your right hand. Just raise it. Pick it up, your right hand. Super. Now you're on your right leg, aren't you?
Uh-huh.
Let's shift over to the left. As you shift over to the left, you supinate the hand. It's coming like that. No, do that. Just stay right on the plane. So unfold the right elbow. Now, you're not cupping this left hand that way. You're coming through here. Your right hand is not fully uncocked. Now the right hand is full uncocked. You got a straight line now to the club head from your right shoulder, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
If you don't get that position, you haven't reached the full release of the club. Now, at this point here, how's that feel?
Different.
I know it'll feel different, but if you want the ball to carry about 30 yards farther, you hit it this way. It goes higher and goes farther. That's right. Now, so a little bit too high a raise of the left heel. Your left heel, yes, right there. Now straighten your right knee a little bit. It's you're having a little difficulty in letting this just go. Now, that's in a free position, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Now, I'm going to take your club head out of left field, and by turning the forearm like that, I'm bringing it almost just slightly toward the center of the fairway, eh?
Okay.
Right. Good. You see how, as he goes back, the whole right side, the whole left side is turning underneath the spine. Here, the whole left side is turning underneath the spine. But I'm not starting it by pushing. I'm bringing it under by pulling this left arm back with a peck like that and turning this right spinae erectae muscle like that. I come this way. I turn the left spinae instead of using the lat to pull. This way, I don't change the arm angle. I got the space between my hands and the ball regulated. Let's see you go. Hit a ball. Let's let it go. I'm hitting it here. I'm working the club head here. Down here, the club head is working me. I picked up club head momentum and centrifugal force that way. Bam! Instead of taking it through there. And you don't feel any loss of direction. If your hand works through this way instead of working this way, you can't keep it in the fairway. Get a duck hook, low duck hook, and the ball roll. It won't carry worth a hell. No, sir, you put your hands back to the address position. Yeah, you see, you try to return your hands to here. My hands are going. Let me show you. Now my arm's in a hang position. I'm coming back to here. Now, to get the hands up higher, my left shoulder blade, the scapula raises, elevates. Now my arm's on a higher plane. I come down, it's on a higher plane and a more out. Now, I'm not going to try to bring this down to where it started. I'm coming here. I've got now control of a plane. Put a ball down there. Watch that left. No, I want to see. My hand's sore as hell right now. If I bury that thing in the ground. See, everything I do is I do with left-handed. I work those things so much I can hardly move them. I hit the guy and knocked him out. I hit and broke those two fingers. He tried to hit me with a golf club. And I stopped the golf club about that far from him, and from right there to there. And he just, his feet went up to his butt, his ass went to the ground. You know? Watch this. Now, I'm not taking the club that way. That's separating the arm from the body, isn't it? I'm taking this club inward with the pec. It's going inward with the pec, but I'm not taking the arm closer to the body, and it's turning. And the club is making an arc around the right shoulder. Now, when I come down, I don't aim at that line out there. I come down there. I'm coming here at this angle. Now, my hand's going to be up there when I hit the ball, and they were there when I addressed it. Watch it. Pull on that club. Watch my wrist. Well, that club is going away from my body a lot harder than you pulled it. See, I stand this way, but it's hard with that limitation of that right leg there. Now look at my hand. I'm not Arnold Palmer. You know? This club is staying on this point. Isn't it? It is damn two is as meeting. Yes, sir. Now, don't pick it. No, here. Don't pick it up this way. Don't pick it up this way.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thumb back in here.
Yes, sir. You gotta get it behind you. There's as much circle behind you as it is in front of you, but yeah, you gotta, yeah, that's why, that's working with a turn of the right shoulder, your right wrist. Yeah, like that, it comes, but you're not bringing your arms in, you're bringing your hands in, okay? So work around the plane of the shoulders, that's good, okay? Don't push down on that left arm. Don't push down on the left arm. Wind up this muscle right here. Let me show you. And it'll take, now go back with this pec, make his arm come against the body with that pec, and wind up this muscle, and you get a good shoulder turn. That's a spinae rectae. Now I'm using that, look here, the right spinae rectae. You know me on that chart I showed you, there was a muscle coming from this first lumbar going down to the ilium crest. That shortens and pulls the rib cage down onto the ilium crest, like that. But if you push down, your head will go down. If you turn that right spinae, I'm not pulling with the lat. I'm turning with that. Now, when I get here, I take this right hand and pull my left arm up. Because your left arm will only go that far without the raising of the right elbow and hand. Let's see you do it. That's good. Do I make it difficult? That's good. That's very good. Now, go forward now. Yes, sir? Now, you got a straight line there. The back of the hand is facing the target. Your right hand hasn't straightened out yet. Now it has. Now you got a straight line from your right shoulder to the hand. Now, that's the completion of the hand action as far as hop extension is going in this. Right there. No, don't pick it. Don't pick the club outside your line of your arms. Break them under. Break under. In. That's right. Now, you brought your hands down in here instead of up there. Out, out. Now shift to that right leg. Hop, extend the right hand. Good, now throw. No, unleash it, let it go. The third lever never worked. Look here, first lever, body and left humerus bone moving. You feel like you put some energy in the extensors of the left forearm, then the hands, okay? All right, third lever. Second lever, wham. First lever's body and humerus bone, okay? Do it again, hit it down. Now make a full swing. 1,001 to the top, 1,001 to the finish. Come on. 1,001, 1,001. That sounds like you hit a rubber ball. That ball went out that pretty good, though, didn't it? Set up the right leg post. Turn the left side in between. That's good. Okay, that looks good. Right heel is coming over the big toe of the right foot. The whole right side is turning around. Let me see you make a swing, practice swing. No, straighten your right knee. Now your head is staying pretty steady, but I'd like to see a little more movement to your right hip, into the right hip. I want to pull it back into that. See, I control my head with the quadriceps. The four muscles come together just above the knee. Now, if I do like this, my head drops. But if I straighten, look at my head here. Look. Now, I'm winding from the shoulder down to the ankle. I'm not going to break it in the center by doing a posterior rotation of the right hip. Look. I'm not going to break in the center keeping the knee bent. Look. I'm here. Like a pitcher, he puts his foot in the box. He turns, he steps and picks this up and goes and throws, understand? You want to shift your weight, feel like you're supported by the right trochanter. That's where the head of the femur goes into the acetabulum here, and I'm resting on that. Now, instead of me trying to turn the hips or break down that post, I'm going to wind up my shoulders. Now, look at that. Now, my hip is past my right foot, but when I turn the shoulder, it's going to pull it to there, and I'm on an upright right leg. Is that clear?
Right hip's going to come back as you turn your shoulders.
Yes, sir. If you try to turn your hip, you got a broken post. Now, you're keeping your weight on your left leg. Look here. I'm using six levers. There's two of them, though. I use ankles, knees, hips, and shoulders. My ankles and knees are going this way. I'm not doing that. You lock out the knee and ankle. I want them all in there. See, my left foot is everting and extending. Left knee is flexing. Left hip is flexing. See that? It's not there. That's... Okay. Now, would you do me a favor? Would you put your feet a little bit closer together? You see, let me show you something. If you stand this way, you can never make this knee touch that knee. You stand here, I want to balance this way and come into that one like that. They're closer together, about 15 inches in between here. Now take a swing. Now you're balancing. Now straighten the right knee. Now straighten your left elbow. Let me pull your arms up a little bit. Keep this as close as you can to there. Keep these condyles close together. Now let's take his right hand and pull the left thumb up like that, okay? Right. Now, instead of having the club shaft rest on your shoulder, have it like that so you swung like it, you wouldn't cut your head off. That's better. Now your club is horizontal, and your hands are now, look at it, you got some good hand expand above your right shoulder, right? Now go. Have you hit it? No, you haven't, have you?
We'll get on
for
lunch.
Okay. Look here. I want you, as I come back, we'll say six is here, 12 is here. I'm going to swing my left hand extended up to 11. Okay? I'm going to come in and swing my right hand up to 1. I'm keeping this imaginary line between the base of the neck and wrist the same radius. You don't want to break down that invisible radius, okay? Just like a flimmer. Yeah. Now go. Now, as you come down, I'm gaining. Look how much I gain. I used to drive anybody, any amount of money they could bring. I made a living in Florida in 1929-33, gambling up anybody. I bet a guy $10,000 make a five on a 307-yard hole with a Coca-Cola bottle. Now, I'm not holding this thing and trying to hit down here. As I move, my hand is doing this. My right hand is be doing like that, but I can't use my right hand, you see. Look, my wrist thing is changing, and I catch up. It takes me from here to there to make that club shaft catch up with my arm. That delay of the uncocking of the hand is the biggest bull crap ever written. It's the biggest lie ever perpetrated on the golf swing. If you're going to throw a ball, would you do this? Look. Take your hand back like this and come down to here and try to throw it from there. Just the same thing. You start a hand right there, don't you? You got a football. Now, instead of throwing the football over, you're doing this with a football. Under. Let me see you throw a football underhanded. Okay? Yes, sir. That club will start singing and talking to you if you do that. Now look at the shoulders, past that shoulder. He's past perpendicular. That club is a little bit below the parallel, but I won't hurt you. If you got this club aiming like that, you're going to come out that way. Understand? If you got it coming this way, you're coming under. Out. You see that? Mm-hmm. Let's see it. Get in that position was excellent. Let's see you do it now. Okay, don't break it. Yeah. You feel this pack mm-hmm. is pulling that arm against the chest, right? You hold that against the chest until after you hit the bottom. Now, you're holding this arm in an up position. When you came here, that's as far as your chest turned. When you, your arm is higher. Your arm is higher. When you come back, it's farther away. Now, watch this. Now, move against your left hip. Move. Golf your heel. Look at that butt of the stick. It's coming out toward that ball, isn't it? Now you unfold your right elbow. Did you see that?
Do that again, Mike. Do that again.
That's what I do. Okay. Now shift. In. Shift to the left. Go ahead and step down on like that.
Right
now.
Where'd that club be pointing right there, Mike?
But right at the ball.
The angle of it's more back that way.
Yeah, but you see, now this shouldn't have, this shouldn't be here. You shouldn't. Like that. All right, now at this point, watch it right elbow straighten out and you go out. See that? Okay. Now, see, when you're doing this, see, if you did a single action without any other, it would be extend and flex, and your knees go straight like a perpendicular, like that. Now, when you add a secondary motion to it, you see how that's coming in with this? Look at my hip. And most people standing keep their left hip high. My left hip is tilted below the right hip as I go back. Can you see that?
Mm-hmm.
See, now, I was looking at that Watson. He's trying to turn his hips on a horizontal, and his shoulders on the horizontal, hitting a horrible shot. And mine was one of the best for a while. And hell, I could have told him. He didn't ask. I don't volunteer information for nothing. You don't work for all these damn years without getting paid, you know? Let's see you hit it now. Yeah. Did you understand you're going to, for the pendulum to work, there's got to be 180 degrees.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to bring it to here and make the club and the arm go the hang. It has to go in where the wrists come together, so you got the full hit of the right hand. When you hit the ball, you see my right hand is slightly this way, and then hit it like that. You got the right hand hitting it, but you have to release the left wrist for it to hit it. So you're coming this way, and the hand's going this way. Then they turn over, and then they do that, and they're just the opposite of the right hand on the backswing. And your circle is contained. The plane is
contained. Where that club face would be, Mike, out here.
That's
just
the
hyper extended. Where that club face is.
Right there.
Right before that, it would be.
Right there.
There.
Mm-hmm. And not, you know,
one
you
more
don't.
Time, Mike, on that, please? Can we get one more time?
You don't have to worry about direction if the hand goes through that way. Well, that's right there. Then it comes. And just like that. And hell, the two ends of the club would meet, but because you're coming out of the angle of address, you're going to be higher than the top of the backswing. But the plane. All the great players have swung this way, but they can't explain it because they don't have the background to explain it, how the body is working. I'll tell you right, there's nobody knows how the body works any better than I. I would fight any human being until I had a stroke. I don't care how big they were. And I wouldn't come out second best. I will guarantee it. I'm going to change it a little bit now. That's better.
Yeah.
Hmm? There you go.
Good. Hit it?
Yeah. Excellent. Now, you'll feel, it's almost like a whip, top, like this, and it feels like the arm's going like that instead of coming into you. Understand? So I feel fully extended with the shaft and the right arm after I hit the ball. Yeah, good. Yeah, but not that low. It's.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's touching until.
Yeah, until there, and then you release the peg. And let the momentum of the club pull your elbows up. All right.
Mike, would you talk a little bit more about how that right arm raises left arm?
Well, let me show you something. Now, I want you to do this for me. Pick my left arm up just when I get here. Now, my body, when I do this, see, from the first lumbar. There's a muscle come from here, goes down to ilium crest. That shortens and it pulls the left side into a concave position. I'm also shortening the left spinae erectae. Now, they're working this way to cause the lowering of the left side. The right side I'm using to turn. You push down with this, your head goes down. But if you turn this thing like this, you never lose your altitude of your head. I used to, in Japan, I'd take crystals out of a watch, put them down and put a ball and hit it full force or drive and not break the damn glass because my head is not going to drop. I measure to the ball from my left shoulder, then I put my measurement from right shoulder ball by flexing the right knee, flexing the right hip, and dropping the right shoulder. Ah, yes. Now you feel a little more pressure on your left leg, don't you? Hmm? Now, we're going to shift to the right leg. Straighten the right knee. Let this come in. That's right. Now, you pull up, pull back with that. Man, is that pretty? Is that pretty? Huh? Look at that. Huh? I mean, that's classic. Huh? Hmm? Now, you didn't let it extend. You're trying to let the arm come back to here. My arm, because of the elevation of the left arm and the elevation of the left scapula, see, this shoulder's come up against your chin. This shoulder blade is pulled up. Now, if you let that son of a gun down, you're going to drop in here. Hold it there now. Swing. Now, out to the ball. Huh? Okay. And just straightens the air. It's your impact. You got all the world of room for your arm to get between your shoulders and the ball. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. Right there, that's super. I mean, classic.
A lot of flexibility there.
Yeah. And he's small waisted, you know? Yeah. No. Let it extend. Look here. Yeah. Look here, you want to feel like you throw the club head out in front of you instead of pulling it through there. Look, let me have it. Watch this. Throw it out in front of you. You don't want to come this way. Your head to move, your body move. But you must feel like you're throwing the pendulum out in front of you. I'll do it very easy, you can see it. Instead of, then you shorten it up. Don't pull with the lat when you come forward. Rotate the left spinae erectae. Here, the muscle coming from here, going right down there. I used to have, it looked like an arm here and an arm there going down my back. You know, Jack Lane said I had the best developed spinae he'd ever looked at. I lost all that. I lost 25 pounds. No, don't stay on the left foot. Yeah, the knee came in, didn't it? See, the whole left side. Now, here's my key. I never work with the shoulder here. I work with the proximal end here of the scapula, turning underneath the seventh cervical here. Now, see how this is turning under here? You don't have but a small space in there. It's so accurate. Here, you got a lot of variable. Now, you're going to make this. Come underneath the seventh cervical and hold that arm up. Unfold the elbow, let the wrist go, and turn. Okay? I'm doing it intermittently to show exactly what is happening, but you never think intermittently. It's all a blended motion. All right? All right. No. You're taking your arms there. You know, look here. First level, figure seven, from the elbow to here to my neck, is turning as you turn the body. Second level, elbow to wrist, it's like you're slinging a frisbee. Now the second level is this, third level is that.
Mike, what muscles activate that action?
Well, when you start by this, see, this is the extensors, lungus there.
Oh, it's the extensors?
Yeah. That's pretty damn close. Look at that. Look at that. That, you know, that is a beautiful finish here. His head is behind his center gravity here. His small arch back. And you're working against the rectus abdominis wall. You see, look here. I still have two fillets. Look at that. Now you gotta feel, like this. Look here. Bam! Don't not elbow, hand. Put your hand out. I'm gonna sting the crap out of it. Just no, that one. I won't hurt you, but look at my hand. But if I do this, it don't hurt, does it? Mm-hmm. But that hurts, doesn't it?
A little bit. Never tell you it does.
I mean, that is super. But you had a little flexion in your hand like that. So it had the toe a little bit ahead of the heel instead of letting it come this way. Now, if I want to throw a ball to him, I do that. I'm not going to do this. Just he's hooking it about 5 yards. That's what.
That was a taught thing for me.
Yeah.
Instead of, I've always thought this was a improper action.
Well, but I mean, if you want a long carry or you want a short carry and a long roll, it's with a you know, out of bounds. That is, c'est magnifique. That's beautiful. That's a little classic looking movement. Huh? How's that feel? You feel like you're moving slow motion, but the club is going to accelerate it. You understand?
I can see where that will make you hit it straighter because it's not, the foot base is not.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Sensation of what you want to hit like a sand shot.
Yeah.
Kind of a
scooping, well, it isn't that.
It's not, but that's the sensation that my brain is giving me.
That looks better. You see more. Now, you can play golf and never fear out of bounds.
That would be nice to know.
No?
Yeah, I can. I have a sensation of what this action here.
See, you're now, all you end up just getting to the club instead of dispersed over the arm shaft. Right. You know, it's getting into the head, creating centrifugal force. If you do this way, it'll pull back into you.
Yeah. Get up there, Farley, you're up.
Farley,
there he is.
Okay, Alex.
Now, don't hit it first. I want to see how you get it up there. That's good, right there. Good setup.
Yeah?
Very good. Wait a minute, I'm in the way. I'm in somebody's way. You're shooting? No. Be sure you shift into the right hip and let the left knee come in. Inward. Now straighten the right knee. That's be a perfect position right there. Now shift. Yeah. Pick up that heel. Okay. Now look. Don't swing it into left field.
Okay,
don't swing it into left field. Feel like the club is coming up here, and then when it crosses over, it goes left. Swing. That's the way. Okay. Be sure you.